Hello everyone, welcome back to ConArchy YouTube channel. In our previous videos, we've learned how to model a simply supported beam, assigning our VDL and our UDL loads, and also analyzing them to get our shear force and bending moment diagram. In today's video, we are going to model this truss. It's quite complex but very simple too. So this is our truss here, where we have our members cutting through. We have our pin support here, and we also have a roller support with our loads acting on our trusses. So we will start today's video. So if not like or subscribe, try to do so before we start today's video. It's a new model we are going to start with, so we have to open a new model. So we are going to use our use built-in settings with, because I've already set my unit of measurement and the code I'm using for my design. So I'm going to click OK. Then we'll have to set our grid lines. This is one of the most important parts of modeling. So understanding how to set your grid lines. Let's go back to our drawing and see how we are going to set our grid lines. So looking at this drawing, we are going to look for our number of grid lines in our X direction. So looking at this, we are going to have four grid lines. Let me draw it so you can really see how it looks like. We are going to get our first grid line. Let me change the color so it could be much visible for us to see. So let me go with color green. Okay. So our first grid line is going to pass through the support here. Second grid line is going to pass through C. The third grid line is passing through here, and the last will be passing through the support. So grid lines cutting through the X direction. We have four grid lines, so we are going to input that into our section here. So we already have the four. A number of grid lines in Y direction is just in one plane, so we are going to input one. So we just have one in the Y direction. And also, spacing of grids in X direction. So let's looking at our picture here, our spacing is not uniform. So we can't really use the first option there. We have to custom our grid spacing to suit this model. So we are going to custom our grid spacing. So edit grid data, then display data as spacing as usual. So our first grid space, let's look at how the spacing looks like. We have the spacing between our first grid lines. We have 2 meters. We have another 2 meters. And we have 2 meters over here too. So let's go back to our app. So we have 2 meters. 2 meters. And the last 2 meters. So I think we are good. We can also change the bubble size since the bubbles are bigger here. So let's go with, let's say, 400. It looks okay now. So once you are done, you just click on OK. So number of stories. Looking at our drawing, we have this our first story and this our second story. And up here we have our story height. That means each story is 1.732 meters. So for each story, the height is 1.732 meters. We are going to input that there. So our typical story height will be 1.732, and also our bottom story height is going to be the same. For the bottom, that is this place. And the typical is for any other stories that are on top of this one. But since we only have one story here, the typical story height, we are going to input this one to there, and the ground to 1.732. So 1.732, that's our story. So let's custom our gray space in here. So edit. Oh yeah, we've already done that. Sorry about that. So just okay. And once we are done, we have to select grid only and hit okay. So just looking at that, we have our plan view here, and we also have our 3D view. Let's put this one in the elevation view. Well, it seems he created four stories instead of two stories. So let's go back to edit it. So edit story and grid system. We are going to modify this. I'm going to delete all of these ones. So delete story. And I'm going to delete this one too. I think it's okay now. So we are going to click on okay. And now we just have what we want for our design. So first of all, let's go back to our picture. We have our first beam connecting A to C. So we are going to draw that. So we are going to draw this here, here, and that. That's our trapezoidal shape. So let's go back. We are going to select our beam. So select our first grid point. Move it to the grid point B. Then here. Then down to the base where we have our grid point D. Then back here to get our complete trapezoidal shape. So once you are done, you just hit escape. What else do we have to draw? We have this horizontal line cutting through. So let's see if we can draw that. So our horizontal line is going to cut through here. So we are going to select our beam and try to select this point where it's going to cut through. But looking at it, there's no joint option that is coming for us to place to start drawing our beam from here to like how it shows at the grid points. So for that, we will have to edit this frame, these two frames. So we have to select it and edit it. We are going to divide this beam into two, this member into two. So as we are dividing this member into two, we are going to have a point here that we can start drawing our beam from. So we will go to edit, edit frame, divide frames. So looking at this, we are going to divide our frame into two. So the two is already here. So then based on the number of divisions you want to make in your frame, you input that value here. So we have two here, then just hit on apply, then okay. Now let's put cursor there and just look at that. We now have a joint at this place. So we can start drawing our beams from there. So all we have to do is select our beam, go to that joint, then start drawing our beam all the way to the last joint here. So there we have it. Then just click, press escape on your keyboard. So now we have this horizontal line. What else do we need to draw? We have to draw these lines too. And we know that it's meeting in at the midpoint of this frame. So we also have to divide this frame into two. Just like the one at the bottom, these lines are meeting the bottom frame at the midpoint. So we have to divide both horizontal frames into two and draw these lines to connect them at the midpoint. So let's go back. So we are going to select. So anytime you want to alter a frame, you have to select it before you edit it. So we have our frames we want to edit selected. Then we are going to edit, edit frame, divide frames. So divide into two, then apply. Okay, so as we divided this frame into, we now have a support here, but we don't need a support here, so we have to remove this support. So we are just going to click, select this support, go to assign, joint, restraints, and we will remove this. So removing, you can just put a hinge there. So with the hinge, it allows, you know, the, it doesn't really restrict movement at that joint. So a hinge and apply. Now the support is gone, so we are cool to go. So we are going to click on OK. Then we are going to go back to our modeling. So we now have our joints there. So what we have to do is draw our beams to connect the joints. So we're going to start at this point, draw to the mid of this frame, then go back to the top. That's a grid point C. Then click, press escape on your keyboard. And we also have to draw this same thing at the bottom area. So we have to select our beam again, start at this joint to the mid joint, then back here. And now we have our frame just looking like that. But we have to remember that this place, we have a ruler support, but when we drew the beam, it was a pin support that was there. So we have to change this pin support into a ruler support. So assign joints, restraints, then pick your ruler support, then okay. Now we have our ruler support here. So what else do we need to do? We have to apply our loads at the allocated places. So at C and D, we have 3 kilonewton loads acting in the gravity direction downward. So we are going to select these joints, assign. It's a joint load, so we are going for our joint load and a force. We are going to apply our 3 kilonewton load here. So the global Z, so this is our Z direction. So it's in this direction, but just look at where the arrow is pointing upwards, but we want our force to point downwards. So our 3 kilonewton force we are going to apply there, we are going to negate it. So -3, we are going to consider it as a dead load, then apply. Now we have our 3 kilonewton loads at the joint here.
James was saying that if they eat before the concert.
So once we are done, we are just going to click on OK. But it seems we also have another joint load here. So we are going to select this joint and also apply the load there. The load is 8.1 kilonewton load. So we are going to apply that same load over here, 8.1 kilonewton load. Then apply. Now we have our loads applied and we are done with modeling our truss. But we also have to remember that our members carry its own self-weight. So we have to send the self-weight of these members to zero. So as we've selected all the members, frame, property modifiers, and we are going to send the mass to zero and the weight also to zero. So once you are done, you apply, then click on OK. So we send the self-weight of this members to zero. But one last thing for you to take note, that in modeling of this, we use our beams to model this truss. So the software doesn't know that this is a truss. It considers this as beams connected to each other. So for this software to consider this design or this model as a truss, we have to define this to be a truss. And we all know that trusses do not carry movements in their joints. It's just the axial forces that is in the members and also the members being in tension and in compression. So there's no movement in this structure. So we are going to release the movement in this structure. So all we have to do is select this structure, then go to assign, frame, release partial flexibility. So now we are going to release our movements. So we are going to check the movement boxes. So So we are releasing our moment such that our structure will not carry any moment. So we are releasing every moment in it. Then we are going to hit on apply. Then okay. So once we have done this, our joint will not be carrying any moments. So now the software will consider this frame as a truss. So it seems we are done with everything. So all we have to do is run our analysis. So hit run. Then we are going to save it with a specific name, a unique name. So let's go with truss. Then we are going to save. So the software is going to run the analysis, but in the analysis, it's going to consider our model as a truss. But if we should have left our movements to be fixed that without releasing them, it will consider it as a beam connected to each other. So now our software has done running the analysis, and this is how the deformed shape of our truss is going to look like. Now let's look at the support reactions. So we are going to check with X and Y, apply. Then we have our reactions here. But since we have our reactions, that's 7.05 here, and also the same here. And let's check our axial forces too. So axial force, we are going to click axial force and also show value. So this is how the axial forces in the members look like. So axial forces in each member. And we also have our shear force. So these are the axial forces. We know that some of the members are going to be in compression and others in tension. The negative or the ones in red are in compression, whilst the yellow ones are in tension. So that's it for today's video. I hope you were able to learn how to model a truss. You can also get pictures of truss and also try your hands on them. Hope you enjoyed today's video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel as usual. Thank you.